What's up? What's going on? Today I'm super pumped because I'm gonna try to do whole tutorial in English, so please bear with me. But before we start, roll that intro.
You can have it if you want it. It's gratis, it's for free. There ain't no strings attached, no, there ain't no catch. Take my love, take my love, take me.
Okay, today's topic will be workflow inside the Photoshop. So I'm gonna try to show you what my workflow is and how it's how do I do certain things, especially when you're working for your client and you need to be able to take one step back and refine something and move on from this point. The goal is to have your project, your photograph, your composition, whatever you're working on, as transparent as it can be. So you can jump in any given time and place and make some adjustment along the whole project to have flexibility, basically. So without further ado, let's jump into the Photoshop. Okay, so let's get started inside the Photoshop. Here we got a basic image exported from Lightroom. The thing with Lightroom workflow, sorry, the thing with Lightroom workflow, it's separate video that's somewhere in my channel. And then if we need some retouching to be done, we need to fire up Photoshop and start from here. So I have my background layer. And really quick, I do a couple things. My background layer will remain fairly untouched to be a reference for the changes I have done. So let's make a move tool and then actions. And I have done two actions that speed up my workflow. So I do have frequency separation. So when I press play, frequency separation is done. I have shown you how to do this in separate videos. So basically you create two copies of background layer and then make Gaussian blur and apply image on the high pass filter, and then I group them inside FS, so frequency separation group, to have a chance to collapse this group and make more space in this panel. And then I have dodge and burn, so I play dodge and burn, and for me dodge and burn it's two adjustment layers with masks, so you have to click on the adjustments and curves. You pick the curve, I will show you like this curve, and burn is on the dark side and the dodge is on the bright side, and then I mask it with black mask, so everything is inverted, hide it, whatever. And then from now on, the basic retouch that I do is frequency separation for skin retouch. I will show you, for the sake of this tutorial, I will change something. So I will show you with the stamp tool, clone stamp tool, and alt option, and you can. This will be this fairly not retouching retouch done. I don't know what I'm saying, but you know what I mean. I collapse frequency separation, and then I open Dungeon Burn, and the power of this method of Dungeon Burn is, so I can do flow 12 opposite 60, and to show you how it's gonna affect my image, I will do like this, white on the foreground, and you can see how subtle the change is. So you can very gently change the shadows and the highlights of an image to manipulate the overall look of the image. So I will change this back on. I will zoom, and when you use a keyboard, it's square bracket to change the size of the brush, or if you use tablet, it's you have to hold control and option together, and then touch the tablet and move your cursor left to be small and right to enlarge the brush. So we can shrink our brush something like this, and then we change back to white, and gently try to make some light into this face. You can see it's very subtle, but the goal is to be subtle, to be gentle with this technique, and to make it so light and subtle that no one notices that you've done something, unless you can turn it on and off, and I will show you how it's gonna affect our image. Zoom out, let's zoom out, and okay, something like this, and then I can collapse this, and I can show you before and after. It's very subtle but powerful at the same time. So this is, like I said before, basic retouch. This image doesn't require to be heavily retouched. So yes, I know. So we can do it like this. When I have to do more complex retouch, probably I would duplicate this layer, Command J, and I will do like something like, I don't know, the eyes, yes, eyes, and I would do separate retouching for the eyes. So we can do something like this. We can lighten up the eyes, yes, and now we have the effect, yes, and this applies to whole image. If I have to do some lighting on the edges of the whole body, then I will do Dodge and Burn group for the body or overall image, and so on. So if you do this retouch process as transparent as it can be, you gain something that I will show you in a minute. So I have to lighten this up a little bit. So we do something like this, maybe like this, to gain some light in the background. And then we go to our brush tool, we go to full screen and flow, maybe back to something around 15, 13, 15, okay, capacity 50, slightly larger brush. We have white mask, black foreground color for the brush, and we start to gently taking back this brightness slider effect from his face and arms. Okay, and this is the last thing that I will do to this image. And now we have JPEG. So this JPEG, it's a file from Lightroom, and I need to export this. So I do quick export as, and my settings for quick export is sRGB, full size, full quality JPEG file, and I will save this to my location. This is the basic catalog for this shoot. This is the JPEG from Lightroom, not raw but fairly unretouched, only developed raw files into the JPEG format. Then I will do the separate folder for JPEG from Photoshop, and then we can save it. And then I have to do one more thing: save as, and it's very important to do this, PSD, the separate catalog with separate folder with PSD format files, to have a chance to go back at this point of time and change anything. Because when you open, I don't know, a year from now, I will open this this PSD file. I can jump in wherever I want and make some adjustments, and then save it, export it, do whatever I want with this file without losing any information and any detail, because I do have the basic JPEG file as the background layer, so I basically have everything. So I will show you now the before and after. So working on the layers, working with transparent workflow give you opportunity to have flexibility inside your project and to not to be so stressed when your client calls you and says something like, you know, I like this image but I will change one little thing, and then all the stress is gone because you know that you can fire up your PSD file, change one thing, export it as a JPEG, and send to the client to make him happy and to make you happy. So for today, this is it. I will end at this point. I think I show you everything I use in terms of workflow. Maybe not so complicated project, but the principles are the same no matter what you do and how big your file will be or how big project you will do. If you follow the simple rules that you make everything on a separate layer, make it into the groups to make some kind of order in your side panel, everything will be much, much easier. Keep that in mind and hit this like button, or if you want, smash this subscribe button if you're into, and see you in the next one.